Boom! Et voilà! Scroll bars.
Welcome back! Guillaume here, back from vacation and ready to work on the SIP. The SIP? Yes! The Simple Image Processor. Today we're gonna add a new feature. So far, if you load an image that is larger than the window, you will only see the top left of the image. And without any resizing capabilities, you will miss the rest of the picture. But resizing is a little bit complex to implement, so instead, we're gonna add a scrolling area. Vertical and horizontal scroll bars will let you navigate within the picture. Let's get to it.
All right, here we are in the code. So first, what I want to do is finish the code cleanup. I am not completely satisfied with this MW and also this name here. So what I'm going to do here is replace this main, because it's a menu, by menu main. And also I want to replace the MW underscore bar by, just pound sign. Okay. And I also want to replace the initial width by window width, and also the initial height. Yes, I've done that already. That's why they're in here. By the window height. Okay, now it is much cleaner. So adding a scrolling area is actually adding a new gadget called a scroll area gadget. But it is a specific type of gadget. It's a container gadget. So you put other gadgets within it. And here we are going to put our image gadget within the scroll area. And a scroll area has two dimensions, well, four dimensions, two width and two height. First width and height is the width and height of the part that is displayed on the screen. And the second width and height are the width and height of the total area that needs to be scrolled over, something like that. So we need to add this new gadget. For that we need an ID. So I'm gonna call it scroll image, and then I will add this in the gadget list. Scroll area gadget, calling, my PC is kind of slow. Okay, so where do I put it in the window? Well, I'll put it in 0, 0. It's gonna take up, be in the top left corner, of course. And its size, the first is the display size. It's not written here, but it's the width and height of the display, the part that is displayed. So it is going to be window width and window height. And the two next are the total area, the global area, but it's also going to be window, at first, window width and window height, because we don't know what we are going to scroll. Then I want to add the scroll step. Let's step 10 by 10 pixels. And then some flags. And here I want to say PB scroll area borderless. Here we are. But because the scroll area is a container, you need to close. When you do the scroll area gadget, when you call this function here, it will open a new gadget list. And you need to close here whenever you're done filling in your container. You close the gadget list like this. And here it's good. What I forget to do last time, also what I forgot to do last time, was resizing the window. Why? Well, here we have our menu and we put some gadgets. But the menu takes some height, takes some space in the window, and you need to resize at the window so that the area under the menu is the actual window width and height that we want. So to do so, we just need to call resize window window main. Okay, we are going just to change the height because we just added the menu that take up the whole width but add some height. So we are going to do the pb ignore. So we are going to ignore all three first, x, y and width. Okay, and for the height here I'm going to use image image height. No, sorry, it's not image height, it's window height plus. I'm going to put the plus before because we have menu height, it's a function, plus window height, like this. Okay, let's try. Will this work? It does display something. Open, we can choose our image, but no scroll bar whatsoever. Okay, another quick thing, I'm going to remove so comment control B and control B here. I'm going to remove the message requester because it's annoying. And what we need to do is we need to, whenever we load the image, we need to change the dimensions of our controls, of our gadgets. We need to change the dimension of our image gadget to fit. So resize gadget, gadget main image, we need to resize this to fit the correct size of the image. So pb ignore for the x, pb ignore for the y, but for the width and height we need to take the image width of our image main. Okay, and sorry, the image height also of our image main. Voila. But we also need to resize, or not really resize, but change the some attributes of our scroll area, because we need to change the size of the scrolling area. So set gadget attribute, that's how you call, that's what you call to change one of the attributes of your gadget. Set gadget attribute, which gadget? Huh, well, we know the scroll image, of course. Which attribute? That's a pb scroll area. So what is strange here is that it is inner height and inner width, which is strange because it's actually the outer width and outer height that you are changing. It's the area on which you are scrolling. So, but, and here you put the value, and the value is exactly the same as this guy. We could have put a variable, temporary variable here, and we need to do the same for the height. Okay, let's try this. F5, open an image, our cube image, boom, et voila, scroll bars, vertical, horizontal, and we can see the full content of our image. Good job.
That's gonna be a wrap for today's video. If you enjoyed it, hit the like button. If you're new to the channel, you can just subscribe. And if you want to give me some new ideas, some advice or some feedback, please drop a comment in the comment section below. If you want to get yourself a copy of PureBasic, just go to the purebasic.com/pp link. It's in the description box as well. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye.